One down, four up production. Quiet on the set, scene one, take two, and action. Hello, YouTubers, subscribers, and friends. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to tinker around with this Yamaha Riva. I haven't done anything to it since I got it last Friday. Today's Monday. And I just got home and I had nothing to do, so I figure I'll come out here and mess around with this fuel pressure regulator thing here. I'm going to take it off and see if I can clean it up. And I was going to buy some stuff at Walmart with carburetor cleaner, but they didn't have any. They're all out. So it's weird because I've been looking on YouTube, watching videos on YouTube on this Yamaha Riva. I haven't been able to find this year. It's an 86. Yeah, an 86. And this has, what's this, 79 cc's. And all the ones that I've been finding on YouTube have 125 or 180. And they're like 1989s and stuff like that. And I haven't been able to find my year yet. So one thing is weird here is all the ones that I've been looking at that shows the carburetor and the petcock where you can turn the gas on and off, they all have the little thing you can turn. This one doesn't have a gas thing to turn off the gas flow. Now this is where the gas comes in and that's where it goes out. So I'm going to take it apart. It's weird because I've looked everywhere for trying to find the shutoff valve for the gas. I don't see one. But that's what I'm going to do today. Gotta get my rubber gloves on. Alright, I disconnected the fuel line and it's dripping still. Trying to put a screw, I don't have anything else to put in that to stop it from leaking. I don't know how old the gas is anyways. When people say the thing has been sitting, you never know how long their stuff has been sitting, really. Oh, that looks like that'll work. Take these lines off here. I'm not a certified mechanic. I'm certifiable, but I'm not certified. I like to take things apart. That's how I taught myself everything I know. Ooh. Hit my head on the damn handlebars. The other day I took this hose off and it came off super easy, and now it does not want to come off. There we go. I gotta remember which ones go where. This goes there. That's the fuel line. This is the top carburetor. I'm messing with the hoses here. Taking them off one at a time. Trying to remember where they go. That's the top. Top goes to the top. And this goes to the bottom. Bottom. Oops, don't want to get that mixed up. This one, better so I don't forget, I'll film it. This one right here to the bottom here goes to behind this pole. Leaving myself a mess of chair in case I forget. I know where to put it. Right here. Squeeze in between there. There you go. Right here, right here. Now, I don't want to get my freaking thing all smelly with gas. My camera. Put rubber gloves on, but still got gas on them. Take this thing off here. I've never taken one of these things. I've never worked on a scooter before. This would be my first. I'm busting my cherry. I worked on motorcycles, but nothing as lapid as this. It's the first time I've ever seen a fuel line set up without a shutoff valve. I'm wondering if this comes off here. It's got a bolt type thing here, and I wonder if there's a filter in there. I've had a carburetor, I had a 67 Buick one time that would start up perfectly and run, and I would drive it, and then after 10 miles it would just shut down like it ran out of gas. And then I would let it sit for a while, like 10 minutes and then start up fine again, and it would run, drive another 10 miles and shut off. And then I found out that the inline fuel line going into the carburetor looked something like this, but the fuel line came in here and it was fat like that, and it had a square thing here. And I unscrewed that, and there was a filter inside that carburetor. And I took that filter out and threw it away, and then put it all back together and drove and got my car home and found out it was that filter. And the guy told me that the gas, you know, gas heats up and expands the filter, and it plugs it, it's all dirty, plugs it up, and it will shut off the flow of fuel. So I'm just wondering, because fuel is going in, but it's not coming out over here. So I'm just wondering. All right, I gotta clean this whole area up. It's all dirty. It's really nice outside. It's about 70 degrees out right now. And get a good shot here. I wanna get my camera smelling on, I guess. If it ain't the mosquitoes, it's the damn ants. I don't know where those ants are coming from. Forgot to get my pliers. I was gonna get pliers, take that filter, see the filter. Now, mosquitoes. Now I'm reminded why I don't like working outside. Okay. My schnauzer out with the big dogs. He's acting like he's a big dog now, running around the backyard. I do that. My wife don't like me to do that because it gets real stinky, but I do it so it tires him out, so he doesn't have so much energy. For little screws, these things start taking a long time to screw. So yeah, I go get my work done in the morning, come back, play with my scooter. I forgot I was going to stop at Ace Hardware and find a kind of plug to plug that fuel line up, because that screw, it's still dripping gas. I can't believe that the pressure coming out of that fuel line is still leaking, even though I shoved a screw down in there. And I tied one of my other gloves, use it as a rope, and show you what I'm talking about. I tied it up here and pulled it up, so, but it's still dripping out of there. It's so weird, man. I've never had that done happen. I've plugged fuel lines before with screws and never had them leak. But the gas is leaking out of there. Oh my God, that thing is taking forever to unscrew. Go down to the settings if you don't want to watch this unscrewing, and hit the fast forward and speed it up. And oh my God, the mosquitoes are eating me up already. I'm gonna have to go put on some sweatpants. Springs in here. That thing's bone dry. I don't know if it's supposed to be bone dry. This peeling off like that. I'm wondering. Does that even come off? Yep, there it goes. There's gas inside of there. I don't have any carburetor. You know what I have? I do have something I can squirt down in there. Electronics cleaner. Let's see, which one would be the fuel? This one right here. I have to go get my electronics cleaner, squirt down in there, see if that's plugged up. Looks pretty clean in there. See if that's plugged up inside of there, and get my pliers, and this looks like plastic here. Let's see if I can unscrew that. Well, time to ruin another pair of gloves. Sometimes you just gotta say to yourself, what would MacGyver do? You know, I don't have any carburetor cleaner. I had to drink some water, and I got these gloves at Walmart. It was like a dollar or something for a pair of 12 because I forgot to stop at Harbor Freight and get me a box of 100 Nurdle gloves. So, like I said, I don't have any carburetor cleaner. And this is the first time I ever thought of this idea. But, this might be, I don't know, it might be bad. The little pump action here. But, let's see if I can get it working though without wasting money on something I don't really care about. So I got this right here, this electronic cleaner. And that's what I use. Ooh, that's what I use to dust out my computer. It's not plugged up. I got pressure coming through there. Hey. It won't shut off. I'm gonna waste a whole can here of this stuff. None of these lines are plugged. I got pressure coming through them. Yeah, I got pressure coming through all these. So unless that filter is plugged up, there's no reason why. There's no reason why this shouldn't be pumping gas through here. Because I have, I can hear it. The camera's picking that up. There was a puddle of gas in here also. So I'm wondering if that little what is that thing called? Everything is. I can't get this thing to shut off. Cheap Walmart shit. Still going. This can is freaking frozen cold, man. It's forming ice on here now. What a waste. This was a whole can. Damn it. Oh, finally stopped. Now I'm wondering if this, where am I at? If this will come off here. Yep, sure enough. It unscrews. Let's find out what's inside here. It's pretty dirty. There's a little screen inside here. But, yeah, I still don't see why that wouldn't. It's not plugged up. Although it is dirty. No reason why that shouldn't be pumping gas through there. So, unless something's not created in a vacuum, this is not dirty. I mean, that screen I can see is pretty clean. While I'm doing that, I got this here. Not plugged, that's for sure. The way that gas is dripping into that thing, too, so there's a lot of pressure coming out of there. No reason. Only other thing I can guess would, Wow, where'd that spring come from? That's the first time I noticed that spring. There was no spring in this thing. That's cleaned out. So there is a screen in there. It's not a filter, it's a screen. So that's something new I learned. And that wasn't on there very tight either. What they call a Mexican socket set, these adjustable wrenches. Alright, so I'm guessing that spring went over here because it was near this. I don't remember seeing a spring inside of here. No, it don't fit in there. All right, well, let me put this all back together. I don't want to bore you with me putting it back together. All right, save you the boredom of me putting everything back together. I got it all back together. I hooked up the battery. Before I put this fuel line on, it comes out so fast, I stretched over here and tried to shoot a fuel down to this other side here. I'm wondering, because if it's not going through here because of that vacuum pump, fuel vacuum pump, whatever that thing is called on the inside there, that rubber thing that pumps, makes a vacuum over here. That thing is not working right. I thought maybe I just transfer gas from here to here, just avoid this middle guy, and maybe I filled the bowl up, and then I kicked the thing about 7 or 8 times, and now I'm going to see if it will start. So let's see what happens here. I don't have a battery charger, so I'll run my battery down. Smells like gas. I don't have a spark plug tool remover to see if that spark plug, I know it's getting spark to the top of the plug over here, but I don't have a spark plug remover tool. I have one for a 2-inch ratchet, but I don't have a ratchet. My brother snagged it from me. So, smells like gas. There is no choke on this carburetor, which I find extremely weird. So unless the gas thing go inside that hose there. I got good throttle. Yeah, well, it ain't gonna start, so I don't wanna kill my battery. Because I don't have a battery charger. I'm gonna have to invest in some tools, something I didn't want to do. Spark plug tool remover. Let me disconnect this battery here. But yeah, if anybody's got any ideas what they think it might be, I mean, other than having starting fluid to see if it will start with starting fluid, because Walmart was out. They were out of starting fluid and they were out of carburetor cleaner, which is very weird to me. Usually they got a crap load of that stuff. But I'm pretty sure that's bad. But is it creating a spark on the spark plug? That's what I need to do. I need to take that spark plug out and test that spark plug, because I don't know if the spark plug's bad. But I don't know. Maybe I should just fill this carburetor bowl with gasoline. And that way I know for sure that there's gas in the carb. And I don't know, I'm just thinking out loud. I really don't want to invest any money in this thing. I'll sell it as it is if I can. I'm going to have a yard sale. And tell whoever buys it, tell them that that's the problem there. This right here. The tire was moving when I was cranking it. But this is 1986. I have no idea what this could be wrong with it. But getting good. It's got 2 cables here. I don't know what that's about. This one here goes up into the carburetor. And then this one back here goes all the way up under the seat. I mean, do I want to invest that much time to rip the seat off and all the rest of the plastic for something I don't want to invest any money in? Somebody going by on a quad. Is that you, username invalid 16? Nope, that's a chick. So, what could it be? The throttle was kind of hard before I took the carburetor apart and cleaned the carburetor out. It's not perfectly clean, but it's clean enough to where it should run. It might run rough or something. But anybody out there? Man, it smells like gas big time. Probably because all the gas I spilled on the ground too. I gotta buy a battery charger again. That's, you never know how much you use one until you don't have one anymore. But I'm not in the mood to spend money lately. Putting every bit of extra money I got into my savings from a motorcycle. So, thinking out loud here to myself. And recording at the same time. Well, let me just end that right now. So, don't make this even more boring than what it is, I think. But, I took that apart. There's nothing plugged inside of that because I used my Ultra Buster electronic spray cleaner. And made sure everything was flowing pretty good. Unless I'm not getting any kind of vacuum from here. But I blew through these hoses and there was no restriction through these hoses. You know, I took them off and I blew through them. And, you know, they're clear. The only thing I can think of is maybe the spark plug is not sparking. Even though I'm getting spark to the spark plug cover here, maybe I'm not getting it on the spark plug. I don't know unless until I get a spark plug remover tool. Take the spark plug out and then test it for spark. But I know I'm getting spark to this right here, this thing here. Or getting spark from that. I put my screwdriver in there. But yeah, I know why the guy wanted to sell it now, because you know he's not a mechanic, neither am I, but I like to tinker on stuff. And I don't need this for transportation, so it doesn't matter if I get it done right away or not. But there you have it. That's my trying to figure out the problems one thing at a time. Getting a headache, getting high from the smell of this gas. So I'm going to call this a video. End it now. So thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe. Hit the like button. And if you have any comments, I'll take the time to reply to your comments. If you take time to leave a comment. And if you got any ideas, anybody out there watching this video that might think what the problem is, let me know. I appreciate it.